What up, everybody in the YTBC? Big shout out to hashtag come back to boxing. Big shout out to Boxing United. I want to go ahead and congratulate Deontay Wilder on his impressive first round knockout on Jermaine Stiverne. And I say that very unsarcastically. I know I've been a person who has criticized Deontay Wilder, but I have to admit I did not expect him to knock out Jermaine Stiverne in the first round. And any time that you train for 8 weeks or more and you can go into that ring and make short work of your opponent, knock him out in the first round, that is something to be proud of. So I hope Deontay Wilder relished in his victory. I hope that he tucked in his daughter goodnight and, you know, that she was proud of him. So, big respect to Deontay Wilder on that. Now, I've been hearing a lot of things since the fight. And to be honest, I've tried to record this video a couple times and it just never came out the way that I wanted it to. But I do feel that there are some people not giving Deontay Wilder his just due. Let's be honest. Jermaine Stiverne is not a Rod Salka, so, you know, I think he deserves at least a little credit. But on the other end of the spectrum, I'm seeing people who are giving way too much credit. Like, just a ridiculous amount of credit. Just because he knocked out Jermaine Stiverne. Let's be honest. This wasn't Tyson Douglas and Wilder was the Douglas going into that ring. Wilder did what he was expected to do. He just happened to do it in a shorter amount of time than expected. That's the fact. I'm not trying to take nothing from Deontay Wilder, but this didn't really further his career much more than before the fight. It did, of course, make the fight a little bit more intriguing. You know, the fight between him and Joshua made that fight a little bit more intriguing because we didn't expect him to make such short work of Jermaine Stiverne. But let's be honest, this is Jermaine Stifuckinverne. And just the fact that he was the mandatory for the WBC belt is questionable. Let's really think about how Stiverne got to be the number one contender. The fact is, he was supposed to fight an eliminator with Povetkin. Povetkin popped dirty. And the WBC basically told Stiverne, we are not going to sanction this fight. You can fight him if you want, but we're not sanctioning it. So what did Stiverne do? He packed his bags, got the hell out of Dodge, and went home. Now, the WBC, in my opinion, they did a terrible job in that situation. They should have said, look, we understand if you don't want to fight a guy who is testing dirty. We're not even going to sanction it, whether you fight him or not. But in order to get the number one contendership, then you need to fight somebody in the top 15. You need to make a fight. Give him a deadline to make that fight. And if If it's really that hard to get somebody in the top 15 from the WBC rankings, then they can make an exception and say, hey, if you can get a fight with somebody in the top 15 and one of the other rankings, IBF, WBO, WBA, we'll accept that. We'll work with you on it. But what did Stavern do? Nothing. He went home, and that's it. And he was given the number one contendership. I don't really put that on Stavern. I mean, I kind of do. But really, it's the WBC's fault. Stavern had no business in the ring with Deontay Wilder. He had no business being the number one contender. And I don't put that on Deontay Wilder either. It's not Deontay Wilder's fault that this situation happened with Ortiz. And it's not his fault that Povetkin can't keep his shit together. Because he got popped twice. So, you know, that part, it's not up to Deontay Wilder to make sure that the WBC is doing what they're supposed to do. And I'm not going to get into any theories, you know, conspiracy theories that Deontay Wilder paid them or anything like that, because even though that's a possibility, I have no way to prove it. And I'll be honest, I don't believe that he did. That's just me. But, you know, for those who have conspiracy theories, I don't blame them either. Everybody is entitled to have their own take on the situation before us. But I personally am not with the conspiracy theories. But that's why I think you shouldn't be giving him so much credit. Because what did Bermain Stavern do to earn that number one contendership? I would like for somebody to tell me that. What did he do to deserve that spot? If someone can tell me that and make sense of it, then I will give Wilder more credit than what I'm giving him right now. But I think I'm giving him just the right amount of credit. They put the dude in front of him because the other dude tested positive for a banned substance, not a PED, a banned substance. Everybody made the best judgment call that they felt that they could make. That includes Wilder. And he knocked out his opponent in the first round, who had no business even being the number one contender in the first place. That is what I'm giving Deontay Wilder credit for. But I just find it crazy how some people are acting like this is an all-time great win. There is somebody, and I'm paraphrasing, but this is pretty much what this dude said, is show AJ how you end a fight that nobody wanted to see. Show AJ what power is. This was a live stream that somebody was doing, talking that shit. Now, I mean, I understand they're hyped and everything, and they're happy, but Bermain Stavern ain't nothing. Carlos Takam is 10 times better than Stavern at this point. Dude hasn't fought in almost 3 years. When Takam had two other fights in 2017, won both of them by knockout. His resume is better than Stavern's. He's been in there with Joseph Parker. And these certain individuals don't want to give him credit for knocking out Takam until the 10th round. Well, yeah, Takam is a better opponent. What did you expect? It's apples to oranges. Takam is a Ferrari compared to Stavern. Stavern's a Chevy. He's decent, but he ain't that decent. But what I'm getting at is this. This very same individual, I remember a real fight that nobody really knew who was going to win. And that was Lomachenko and Nicholas Walters. That was a fight that nobody really knew what was going to happen that night. You had some people way on one side. You had some people way on the other side. And then you had everybody in the middle who didn't know who the hell was going to win that fight. And it was equal parts. There was just as many people who didn't know what the hell was going to happen as there was people who thought Lomachenko was going to win that fight. And there was just as many people who thought Walters was going to win that fight. And the night that the fight comes, yeah, Lomachenko didn't knock him out in the first round, but he won pretty much every round. I mean, you might be able to give the first round to Walters, maybe, if you're being generous. But other than that, Walters wasn't doing nothing. And as soon as Walters quits, all of a sudden, Walter ain't shit. All of a sudden, Walter laid down. All of a sudden, Walters is a bum. So like I said, people could criticize all they want, but it becomes very apparent who is extremely biased and who is honestly trying to call it how they see it. You can always take any win or loss and try to twist it in any way that you possibly can to make it seem like a legitimate win or that it was a robbery if your dude lost. Big shout out to old dude, but I'm sorry, I don't see how you saw that Porter robbed Granados. But like I said, big respect to you, L dude. I'm not trying to call you out or nothing like that. I just disagree with the way you saw that fight. But that's what I mean. You could take any win or loss or draw and twist it in any way that you can to make it seem like it's a robbery or that a robbery was legit. So, I mean, it is what it is. I mean, we're just boxing fans. It's all very much subjective in many ways. But now, the thing I'm really trying to wrap my head around at this point in time is how some people are saying that Wilder is ducking AJ and that AJ is ducking Wilder. You know, one thing I will say is this. Jay Cotto, big shout out to him. He mentioned a rumor that Joshua asked for Ortiz to be removed from his rankings. From the WBA, I believe. WBA rankings. And if that is true, then I have to say, I'm pretty disappointed in Joshua, if that is true. At this point, though, I haven't seen anything supporting that theory, so I'm reserving my judgment on that. But as far as Joshua and Wilder are concerned, I can't see how you could say either of them is ducking the other, because it's been just over a week since Joshua's fight, and it's only been a couple days since Wilder's fight. These dudes are resting at home after doing what they had to do. I'm pretty sure nobody is ducking anybody at this time. Let them go to the negotiation table and do what they do. And don't be surprised if AJ makes more money. Don't be surprised if he's getting a larger portion of the revenue. And don't be surprised if it's over in England. Don't be surprised if it's in the UK. But I'll be honest, I think it's a very high possibility that it will be in Las Vegas. I'll be honest though, I don't care where they make the fight, as long as the fight is made. I don't care about all that A-side, B-side shit, to be honest. I'm just saying, don't be surprised if everything I just said came to fruition. Because at the end of the day, Joshua is the one that beat Klitschko. At the end of the day, Joshua is the one who has more belts. And at the end of the day, Joshua is the one who is more proven. I don't say that Joshua necessarily beats Wilder, because the way I see it right now, it's a very 50-50 fight. Joshua doesn't have one-punch power, but he has the kind of power where he will smother you and you don't even know what to do. But on the other hand, you got Wilder, who has one-punch power, who has looked terrible in fights, but then out of nowhere knocks the dude out. Just look at the Spilka fight. Spilka was giving Wilder the business. I don't care what anybody says. Spilka was winning that fight. If the fight would have ended before the knockout and they would have went to the scorecards, Spilka would have won. And at the end of the day, both these dudes have suspect chins. The only difference is Joshua's chin has actually been tested. So we know that Joshua doesn't have the best chin. But Wilder, let's just be honest, yes, he has more fights than Joshua, but he's also fighting old-ass flabby dudes. Yeah, Klitschko is not a spring chicken, but guess what? He stays in shape. You cannot compare Bermain Stiverne to Klitschko. You cannot compare Chris Areola to Klitschko. You can't compare any of Deontay Wilder's opponents to Klitschko, really. And that's just fact. But like I said, Joshua has a suspect chin. If he gets caught by that right hand, it doesn't matter if he's winning every round up to that point. Wilder will win the fight if that happens. That's why I say this is a very 50-50 fight. I think it's going to be very interesting once that fight happens, just as long as it does. That's all I care about. Now, there's some talk about, well, they should build up the fight. There's some talk about, why not the fight now? Where I stand? All right, my apologies. As I was recording, a phone call came through. And with this app, as soon as a call comes through, it ends your recording. So if it seems like this part of the video is disjointed from the first part, that's because it is. But anyways, I think the last thing I was talking about is that if Wilder catches Joshua, then it's over. And it doesn't matter if Joshua wins every round up to that point. That's very much a possibility. It's a very 50-50 fight. But at this point, I think it's very premature to say one is ducking the other. Like, you have to realize, after these dudes have been in the ring, they're sore, they're hurting. They have families that they have not spent time with because they've been training. Do you not think that is reasonable that a couple weeks after the fight, even a month, that they get to spend some time with their families before they start going to the negotiation table for the next dude? Don't focus so much on what these promoters say. They're fucking promoters. You can't trust them as far as you could throw them. And that's just fact. There is no reason to get all loyal toward a certain promoter, because all they care about is the money. It's very apparent. You don't believe me? Just look at De La Hoya. When De La Hoya was fighting, he fought everybody. Now that he's a promoter, he's all about we have to build the fight, and we have to do this, and we have to, you know what I'm saying? He talks all this bullshit. It's the same dude, but guess what? It's different when you're a promoter. He ain't thinking about legacy. He's thinking about money. Because at the end of the day, when it comes to his fighters, whatever legacy they have is not his legacy. His legacy is done. His legacy is cemented. You think he really cares what Canelo's legacy is? No, he cares about how much money he can milk out of him. Now I remember what I was talking about before that call came in. So what I was getting at is this. There's a lot of talk about that the fight should be built up. And then on the other end of the spectrum, we got people saying, why not the fight now? I'm in the camp of why not the fight now? And that's simply because I'm just a selfish fan. I hate that these undisputed champions get prolonged so for such a long time, and it's just irritating to me. But I realize, yeah, it's still a business. They got to try to make the money that they can. So I try to put my selfish ways aside and say, all right, why shouldn't these guys make as much money as they can? So I'm going to leave you all with this, all right? Just take a seat and sit back, all right? There's no need to try to get everybody else on YouTube convinced that fighter A is ducking fighter B. Because at the end of the day, these fighters don't know y'all. These fighters, as much as they care about you is the extent of the money that you're going to put in their pockets. If you're buying their pay-per-views and you're buying their merch, they're going to care about you just a little bit more than the person who is streaming the fights. But guess what? It's not going to be by much. Because you buying a $25, $30, $45 shirt ain't shit compared to the hundreds of thousands of money that they make in one night. So stop being so loyal. There's no hate. There's no debate. There ain't nothing you can do that will change the outcome of a fight. And as for other people just being critical of Wilder or Joshua, don't get me wrong. I understand it can strike a nerve and it can be annoying when you hear all this garbage about, like I said, you know, people talking about one dude is ducking the other right now. And it's literally been just over a week since Joshua fought, and it's been a couple days since Wilder fought. It's very annoying to hear all this stupid ass rhetoric. I get it. But remember, if the greatest of all time, Muhammad Ali, can be criticized, if he can be criticized for knocking out George Foreman, who everybody thought was going to beat him, everybody thought he had not a chance in hell, if he could be criticized for getting a knockout win on George Foreman, you best believe Wilder can be criticized for knocking out Bermain Stiverne. You best believe Joshua can be criticized for knocking out Klitschko. That's just the way that it goes. Some people just are hateful bitches. That's just the way that it is. And if they are just hating without any legit reason, then fuck them. Leave a dislike on the video. Don't watch their videos no more. But at the end of the day, it ain't worth getting your blood pressure all high. It's not worth threatening people. It's all just opinion. It's all, it just is what it is. Trust me. If you treat your fandom of boxing like how I'm outlining for you, you will be a much happier fan. This should be a fun hobby. This shouldn't be some shit that gets you all bent out of shape. But anyways, to all my subscribers, anybody watching my videos, or if you just so happen to stumble on this video, let me know what you thought. Please leave a comment. Hit me up. And you have a wonderful and blessed day. Peace.